Summary. Predictably irrational. The hidden forces that shape our decisions. Proudly brought to you by Readtrepreneur. World's best book summaries. Narrated by Oliver Hunt. A note to readers. In this section, author Dan Ariely welcomes readers to his book Predictably Irrational, The Hidden Forces That Shape Our Decisions. He narrates how he has observed the inconsistencies in the actions of humans, including the way they make decisions. He has tried to study these irrational actions with the aim of coming up with methods that would improve our decision-making skills and eventually lessen the mistakes that we repeatedly commit. His interest in studying this aspect has led him to learn more about behavioural economics. He studied human idiosyncrasies, asking himself, why do we continue to accept false beliefs despite knowing that they are not true? Why do we prevent ourselves from telling a lie every time we are reminded of the Ten Commandments, even if nobody could possibly know that we are lying? What is the impact of emotions on the way we make decisions? With these interesting questions alone, we would know that Ariely and his team of researchers indeed enjoyed assessing their study subjects in their quest for answers. Nonetheless, Ariely adds that he also experienced dissent in his experiments on irrationality, specifically from professional investors. However, the 2008 global financial crisis opened up opportunities for people to learn more about behavioural economics. Yes, the crisis was truly a distressing time, but it also opened up opportunities for people to consider better ideas to avoid making the same mistakes. He mentions that even writing a book in this day and age, in which email and blogging are highly prevalent, allows him to study more about human behaviour. Introduction. How an injury led me to irrationality and to the research described here. Ariely recalls being told by a number of people that he has a unique perception of the world. This gift allowed him to enjoy his research career, specifically in finding what impacts the decisions we make in our daily lives. He poses questions such as, why does a 1 cent aspirin prevent us from curing our headache, but a 50 cent aspirin quickly takes our headache away? Why do we always find an urgent need to purchase things we don't actually require? Why do we tell ourselves that we will finally go on a diet, but still keep on eating anyway? Ariely promises to answer these questions by the end of his book and explain to us its connection to our business life, personal life, and basically our life in general. For instance, the effectiveness of a 50-cent aspirin may have something to do not only with our choice of medicine, but also with the issue on health insurance. Perhaps, if everyone is consistently reminded of the Ten Commandments, then the Enron-like fraud may have been prevented. All these are explained by the author through scientific studies, results, and anecdotes. In this section, Ariely also narrates that his interest in studying this field of behavioural economics began after meeting an accident when he was only 18 years old, wherein an explosion caused him to have third-degree burns. This accident allowed him to experience various types of pain. His stay in the hospital gave him the opportunity to be with different types of people and learn more about different attitudes and behaviours. Soon, when he began his life as a college student, he found himself quickly relating all his experiences to his college lessons about the physiology of the brain. Eventually, he expanded the scope of his experiments, highly focusing on assessing cases about people committing mistakes repeatedly. Ariely's book mainly focuses on people's irrationalities as we all go through the journey of life, and it is through the field of behavioural science that he enables himself to study all about it. Behavioural economics, also known as judgment and decision-making, focuses on both economics and psychology, and therefore widely differs from conventional economics. Through behavioural economics, Ariely has not only studied about people's behaviours, but also about our capability to make decisions. Through his studies, he has learned that people are not merely irrational, but are predictably irrational in general. Our illogicality consistently transpires whether we act as citizens of our country, as lawmakers, as businessmen, or as consumers. Ariely mentions that each chapter of the book is based on several studies he conducted with his colleagues. Chapter 1 explains our habit of comparing things that are conveniently comparable and shaking off those that bring inconvenience. Chapter 2 talks about how the initial decisions we make eventually become part of our long-term behaviour, while Chapter 3 ponders on why we tend to get excited over free products and services. Chapter 4 offers information on social norms and market norms. In Chapter 5, Ariely examines the impact of sexual arousal on human behaviour, while in Chapter 6, he discusses the tendency of people to procrastinate. Chapter 7 focuses on how and why the value of a thing is always higher in the eyes of the owner, while Chapter 8 ponders on our tendency to grab all available options right in front of us, leaving us emotionally, mentally, financially, and physically exhausted. Chapter 9 dissects the effect of expectations on our lives, while Chapter 10 examines the correlation of expectations to both objective and subjective experiences. Chapter 11 talks about the tendency of people to become dishonest, while Chapter 12 looks into the correlation between money and honesty. Lastly, in Chapter 13, Ariely offers his views on behavioural economics, human behaviour, and predictable irrationality. Free bonuses. P.S. Is it okay if we over-deliver? Here at Readtrepreneur Publishing, we believe in over-delivering way beyond our readers' expectations. Is it okay if we over-deliver? Here's the deal. We're going to give you an extremely condensed PDF summary of the book which you've just read, and much more. What's the catch? We need to trust you. You see, we want to over-deliver, and in order for us to do that, we've to trust our reader to keep this bonus a secret to themselves. Why? Because we don't want...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.